Hey everybody, this is Ori from Master Web, and today I'm going to share another video about Zendesk, particularly about Zendesk Live Chat. In the past, we've made some videos about Zendesk Support, which is a ticketing system that you can answer questions, keep track of the communication between your customer and your business, your customer service agents, your sales, etc. Today's video is talking about the part called Zendesk Chat or the Live Chat functionality. So what does that mean? Live chat. So live chat is a widget that you can put on your website like this, that you can, the customer can click on it and they can fill up their information and start chatting with you, sharing information, asking questions. And it's just a way for you to connect better with your customer and your customer to connect better with the business. Rather than just submitting a form or making a phone call, you can allow live chat. More and more businesses are using this, and it's a great feature by Zendesk, and it connects also to other things. Like if you use Zendesk Support and Live Chat, then when someone when a customer actually opens a chat, it creates automatically a ticket in support, and it connects to different parts. So it's really good. So today I'm going to share with you the back end and a real example of how it works, so you can see settings, everything. Okay, so first of all, what I want to do is I want to show you a very basic chat right here, okay? So this chat itself is, this is a website, these are some apps that we make, and I'm going to use this to share a real example. So on this website, if customer wants to actually contact us, they can click on chat right here, and let me actually open a new window. Let me show you this. Okay, so now the customer can go and they can chat with me right here with the business. For example, my name is Bob and I'm just gonna make up something, okay? And hi, I have a question about shipping, okay? So just for example, so now they started a chat, and now if you heard that beep, now the business itself, so I'm gonna show you a business, has a request right here to serve a chat, okay? So I can click here and serve, and now I can chat with the customer. So what you can see, if the system has recognized them as their email address of having other tickets in Zendesk Support, you can see their history. You can see how long they spent on the site, where they came from, for example, Google or Facebook or direct, which page they're on right now, and if they visited multiple pages. So for example, let me go here to the privacy page, and you'll be able to see the where they are, so you can have more context about them. And you'll be able to see their name, their information, and where they're located, their browser, and then you can start chatting with them. Hi, you know, I'm sorry that you have an issue or a question. You know, what can I help you with? And I can also attach files. I can put, and I'll show you a few more things a little bit later. Okay, so I can see more about them, a little bit about them. Okay, and the customer, you see, they see the agent's image and they can start chatting with them and thank you, that's it. For example, I can answer, okay? Let's say I like my chat. Okay, so now I finish the chat, I can close the chat up, right? So for example, I finished and I can end the chat. Okay, so now I had a very, very basic chat right here. So this is the most basic thing you can do. Now let me show you some things about setup and other things. Okay, so first thing you need to do is obviously you'd register an account and you have to choose your plan. So there's three plans. There's the basic, the pro, and the enterprise, and each one have different features. So in the video, I'll give you the link to the section here. We use the most basic plan, the most basic paid plan, which is basically the light. And in this video, we only have one agent, but I'll show you some things about this, okay? So let's go right here. So first of all, before we actually set up, I want to show you the whole flow. Before we set up and start chatting, we need to set up the settings, the configurations first, okay? Before we even embed the widget here. So first of all, what I'm going to do, I'm going to check my agents. I'm going to go to settings to the backend, and I'm going to check my agents. So here I only have one agent. An agent is someone that can log in the backend to chat with the customer itself. So when a customer starts a chat, an agent will pick it up. And if you have multiple, which I only have one in this video, you'll have them, you know, multiple agents right here. Okay, if you want to add another agent, it'll go to Zendesk Support, and then you can add the agent as a staff member and as an agent. And you put their email and their name. Okay, So the second thing you can do is set up departments. If you have more than one agent, then you'll set up different departments. For example, returns, technical support, higher level support, sales, etc. And you're going to associate the agents. So you can set up both routing. You can set up certain tickets going to certain departments or certain agents. And you can also transfer them between agents. So for example, if an agent picked up the chat and they couldn't answer that question because it's out of their skill set, they can transfer the ticket to the other agents or the other departments. Okay, roles are a way for you to allow certain agents to access certain parts of these sections and have access to do certain things. For example, change settings in the back end or serve chats, things like that. Okay, the next one is routing. So this one, we don't have it in our plan. So I'm going to just skip this for now. And in future, hopefully we can do a video about this. Okay, next one, shortcuts. This is a way to save parts of the chat to save things that your customer service reuses, your agents reuse more and more to make it easier to answer questions. Okay, so let me show you an example. For example, so I created a shortcut that let's create a shortcut called shipping. Okay, and anytime a customer asks me what are my shipping policies, let's call it policy. Okay, then instead of me typing it every single time, because it's something I need to reuse a lot, and it's a common question or a common thing I want to paste, I can put the information. So for example, free shipping USA, and these are my policies, for example, no returns on USA orders. And I have, for example, $5 shipping for, whatever it is, okay? So now what I can do is I can specify I can call it, for example, shipping, okay? So now if I create a shortcut and I want to chat with a customer, I can just type in shipping and it'll automatically paste this information right here, okay? So let me show you a few examples a little bit later about it. Now, the nice thing about shortcuts, you can also specify not just text to be automatically used, but also you can allow options for customer to do. So let me show you an example. Let's say customer is chatting, okay, and they're gonna re-chat, okay? So I'm gonna serve the customer, and if I type here shipping, okay, you can see here that there's already these things that it can auto-fill. So I can click here on the latest one, and it automatically will paste that. You see that? So instead of me typing in this whole thing, I can automatically save these and type them in very simply. Okay, great. Let's go to the next one. Let's end this chat. Okay, so the next one is ban. So if you have some customers that you want to ban, maybe they're spam or maybe they're doing something, supposed to. What you can do is you can add them to your ban list by blocking their IP address. You can put the IP address and then they won't be able to chat with you anymore. Okay, the next one is triggers. Triggers are automations that you can set up when a certain rule happens, you can do a certain action, okay? So let me give you an example, for example. So this one, pricing page. If a customer is on a certain page, for example, they're on this privacy page or they're on the home page, or in this example of a privacy page, so you can specify, hey, if the customer visited a certain page URL, for example, pricing, and they're still on the page after 30 seconds, I want to perform the following action, which is I want to send them a message. I want to get their attention. So for example, if they're on this page right here, let's just pretend this is pricing, and they're here, I can pop up a message and tell them, hey, is there something I can help with? So these kind of triggers are here to help you either automate something or get the attention of the customer to do something, okay? So this is a really nice thing, okay? Other than that, you can create your own triggers, okay? And so the triggers always work in a very simple way. Number one, you put the name. Number two, you specify the condition. When does the trigger happen? When the trigger happens when the widget, right? The widget meaning this thing. Is the widget clicked on? Is it not clicked on? Is it before they're chatting? Is it during the chat or is it after the chat? And then you can also specify the conditions, right? So the condition could be a certain page, a certain location, a certain time of day. And you can specify these things to automate. And then once the condition is met, you specify the action. What's going to happen? Do I add a tag to categorize my tickets and my chat a certain way? Do I pop up something? Do I block the visitor, etc.? So these are really nice ways to create things to automate your system to make things better, okay? Especially I like the ones for the add and remove tags, which we'll get into a little bit later, which allows you to organize your tickets and your chats in a different way so you can report on them later and you can organize them later. For example, assign them to a certain department or report on them or things like that, okay? Next one, goals. This is also not in the plan we have, not the light one, but it's in the professional and the enterprise. This is a really nice feature that allows you to set up tracking goals to see how you're doing for your conversions. So let me give you a real example. So let's say I have an e-commerce site and I have my live chat, and I want to see how customer support helps with my e-commerce sales. So I want to set up a conversion. For example, I would set up a conversion saying, anyone that's made an order, they've arrived to the success, thank you for your order page. I want to see their order, how it's influenced by a chat and how it's influenced not by a chat. So what you would do is you'd go here, you'd click on your URL and you'd specify, okay, anyone who visited the success page, I want to report on that. I want to add a tracking, and then Zendesk would provide you reports to see how a chat helped with how certain chats helped with that order. Okay. Okay. Now, the most important part, once you finish your settings, you're going to need to implement on all of your pages the widget itself. So you're going to have to ask your developer to do one time to add your code, right, in between the head tags. So how do you do that? You have to ask your developer. But for example, for me, I used Google Tag Manager and I just added it. So I created a tag, for example. I clicked on create a tag. I made a new tag, for example, Zendesk Chat. And I made it custom HTML. I triggered it on all my pages and I saved it. But you're gonna have to ask your developer. If not, you can put it in the HTML, or depending on what system you have, you're gonna have to ask them to do that. But once you do that, the widget will be live, right? It's gonna be live on all the pages that you wanted to, all the pages you put that HTML on, okay? And the personal one is basically you as an agent. You will have to put in your name, for example, and your avatar, and obviously things like your language, etc. And that when a customer chats with them, they can see your name, for example, and your avatar and others. So these are your personal account. Everything here else is about the business account itself. So let me give you a few examples of what other things you can do. Okay, sorry, one more sip. Okay, so when a customer, so the first thing about chats are the status. So when you as an agent are logged in the backend, you can be on three different statuses: online, away, and invisible. Online is basically you're available to chat with customers. Away is you're not available to chat. And invisible is kind of in between. And invisible allows you to pick up chats, but there are certain things you can't do. So I want to read this a little bit because it's a little complicated. So invisible, away indicates internally to other agents that you're away from your computer. Obviously, other agents, so they can't transfer to you, but you can still serve requests, okay? And invisible is very, very similar, but it's a little different. Allows you to sign in to chat, right? Which is where we are. If incoming chats are broadcast to all agents, invisible can still see and request. But incoming chats assigned to agents, invisible cannot receive or accept. If all agents are invisible, the widget will not appear online to visitors and chats will not fire. So one more thing, a little side topic about this is right here. Let me go here. So if all of your agents are basically away, then the customer will not be able to chat. So you see this chat, the chat itself, let me go here for a second. So the chat itself, I can talk to, let me open a new window for a second. All Okay, so here I can actually chat with someone. So the message itself is, okay, put your name in and you're going to be able to chat right now. We can help you right now. But if all of the agents, for example, I only have one agent, are away. Let me open this. Let me just refresh the page. If all the agents are away, it's going to specify that you need to send a message, right? So let me go here. Let's see. And sometimes it takes a little time to update. This is not. Okay, let's try again. Okay, sometimes it takes a little time to update. But basically, when you click here, it'll say, please leave a message, and then it'll send a ticket, and you'll get an email from it, okay? Because they're all away, basically. So let's talk about a few things. Let's say show you a few examples. So Bob, I'm going to open another ticket. Okay, I just made up a name. Okay, let's just make this up. Okay, hi. I have a question. Okay, so now I can serve this. I can serve this. Obviously, if I have multiple, I can serve multiple at a time. And I serve the information, and you can see these are my old tickets. I can create a ticket, or I can just, let me see here, I can just answer, hi. So if I answer, the system will automatically create a ticket. Where does it create that ticket? It creates it in Zendesk support. So if you have also Zendesk support, you'll be able to see the ticket here in Zendesk support. So it's saved in your ticketing system, and it's saved under everything you've chat about is saved here. So this is a nice thing to do. So hi, I can, you know, send a ticket, for example, to a customer. Okay, so I'm going to click right here. Okay, other than that, you will also get by every single chat, you'll also get an email receipt of your tickets, right? So the agent itself will get a ticket with all the information about the chat itself. Okay, so for example, chat with Bob. Okay, what else can we do in the chats? Okay, so we can add some emojis. Okay, we can, at the end of the chat, we can send a request rating. So, yes, request rating. So if we chat, if we think the customer is satisfied, we can ask them, oh, can I please send you a rating? Can you please rate me? Okay, and then I sent it. And then the customer will have this right here, and they can click on rating, and it was very helpful, for example. Okay, great. They can click here, obviously here. Okay. Now, other than that, I can also transfer to a department, right? So for example, if I can't answer it, I can transfer to another department. And because I'm only one agent in this example, obviously there's no other available agents I can transfer to, okay? I can see some data, I can organize my ticket, I can add more information about my customer, and I can organize the ticket. For example, this was talking about returns, okay? And I can specify. Now, the reason why there's no matching is because I need to create those tags in the back end. So for example, let's just say there's an existing tag, so I can organize it here with customer. This is for organization purposes only. Okay, you can see past tags, past chats and current chats. Okay, so let me close this and let me add it. Okay, so what else do you have here? The home is the dashboard, which you can just easily see some basic information about the chats. Visitors will show you all the visitors on the website currently, where they're from, what pages they're visiting. So you can actually click on them and try to chat. You can actually open the chat for them to get them to talk more. So you can actually click and then the button will open up to try to chat with them. Okay. What else can you do here? You can see the history. You can see all the chats from before, right? So all the customers that have chat with you, and you can have tracking. Analytics is if you have professional and enterprise plans, you can see more data about chats served, chats missed, response times, number, you know, which agents have chat more. You can compare agents between one another to see the performance, things like that, okay? And then monitors also only for enterprise. These are much bigger accounts. You can actually see how the chats are moving in real time. You can see much more about the performance. This I've never seen before because it's enterprise, but just an interesting comment, okay? Other than that, everything is connected to Zendesk support. So once you use the chat, it'll open a ticket in support, and you have everything organized within the same ecosystem. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. One more thing before I go is Zendesk also has a iPhone and Android app. So if you don't wanna, if your agents don't wanna just have your browser open and hear, you know, sounds, you know, beeps for incoming requests and then answer them, you can also have your phone to support. You log in as an agent with your phone app. And in case your support agents need that, you can also use the phone app. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any specific question about the widget, installation, triggers, setup, let me know. I'll be happy to answer any questions and make some more examples. Just ask us questions. Really appreciate you listening to our videos, and we'll make more and more Zendesk and other videos. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.